Parents in Connecticut are absolutely irate about an elementary school teacher who was spared a jail sentence even after the former teacher was accused of sexually assaulting students. I looked at this story and I tried to find that there was some reason for all of this break that this guy got. Did you see it?
You know, that is the first thing that popped into my mind too, is what actually happened here? Mm. Why is he being given this break? So just so people understand, we've got this small town in Connecticut. This individual was an elementary school teacher, started in 1998, 54 years old, been teaching for decades. Mm-hmm. And the children, the little girls, year after year, would come in with these complaints. Listen, he was touching us inappropriately. He was shoving his crotch in our faces. He was a big hugger, they said, taking lewd photographs of us in adult poses. Mm-hmm. And the administration did nothing. The fellow teachers that were told about this did nothing. They got indicted.
Yeah.
But this guy gets off with 0 days in prison.
Yeah. Okay, so when I look at this story, the thing I do love in Connecticut, what is the Alford exception?
Alford plea, yeah.
The Alford plea. The Alford plea is it's no plea of guilt, is no plea of anything. It's just, we're going to let you go, basically, right?
Yeah.
We're going to let you go because we looked at the facts. The facts are pretty overwhelming. He was, he was doing things like touching their breasts. He was doing things like having him sit on his lap, inviting him over to his house. This guy's a child predator. I mean, there's no difference.
Well, and he had the photographs of these young girls on his computer.
Yes.
So there's no question. There is no question at all that this is what happened.
So what do you make of it? Why does a prosecutor say, or a judge? Now, the judge acted like I didn't have any. The judge could have stopped this plea.
Yeah.
You know, the judge tried to tell the dad, who was really angry about it, no, I can't do anything about it. This is awful. She had total discretion to stop the plea. Just so if this story ever gets out, you know this judge had the absolute discretion to say this is ridiculous. Yeah. Her argument that, you know, gee, this is shameful is a ridiculous argument.
It's reminiscent of the Hunter Biden plea deal.
Yes.
The judge in that case said, absolutely not, you're not
going to. I'm not going to
lie. So judges can do that in a heartbeat it's over. But to me, there's more to this story. Unfortunately, we don't have it.
Well, Farron, don't you like at least the part that the people that were supposed to be the administration, they were pulled into it too?
Yes.
And they should have been. They should have been prosecuted as well, because apparently they let it go on for years. Didn't do anything about it for years.
Right, and they had their warnings. They understood what was going on.
Yeah.
It was almost overt with what this man was doing. And so I want, I'm putting out a call to action right here, some good investigative journalist.
I'd like to know the story.
Track
here.
This down.
Yeah.
Find out
yeah.
who his connections are, if there's any family tree, if there's any business going
mm-hmm.
on.
Mm-hmm.
There is a reason he was let go with no prison time. And there's got to be some kind of connection there.
Right now, I'm not seeing the connection because there's not enough in the story.
Right.
But some journalist needs to take a look at this. When you go as far as saying, well, we're going to bring in the administration, too, because they overlooked all of this, there's favors going on.
Yeah.
When it's that serious.
Helped dirty money flow through its branches around the world, including at least 800...
Plaintiffs allege that the defendants provided money and medical goods to terrorist groups Hezbollah and Jaish al-Mahdi.
This is a well-organized business for these individuals that carry out these attacks. Terrorism is a business, and they run it like a business.
They knew about what was going on for a decade. They absolutely, no question about it, knew that HSBC was washing money. They had every reason to understand it was for terrorism and it was for drug cartels. Took no action whatsoever.
These banks are involved. Their accounts are connected and they're using them to mask the transactions. The more complicated they can make the transactions, the more distance they can put between the bad guys and the seemingly legitimate purpose of these funds.
They pay $1.9 billion, which is a drop in the bucket compared to what they've made. And nobody goes to prison. These CEOs, these bankers that made this decision, they're safe at home. They know what they've done. It's resulted in the death of Americans, contractors and soldiers, not just hundreds, but thousands. And we look the other way because they don't look like criminals. The die is cast. The people that are responsible are on Wall Street.
And they don't look like criminals. It's almost a suspension of disbelief. Sometimes I'll have people call me and say, is this real? Do they really get away with this? Yeah, they do.